Hello everyone, welcome to our coverage of the men's water polo competition. We're at the quarter-final stage and our featured game sees the reigning Olympic champions Hungary face Italy in the last eight. Hungary not only won gold in Beijing 4 years ago, but also in Sydney in 2000 and Athens in 2004. But theirs is an ageing side and they've not been in dominant mood since they arrived here in London. Confirmation of the two quarterfinals in this evening session, Italy against Hungary, which we'll see very shortly, and then the USA against Croatia in the last of the quarterfinal matches. Hungary have already lost a couple of games, suggesting they're not quite as strong as they were 4 years ago. This could be an evening when their crown topples. Up against them, Italy, who are looking to improve on the ninth place they achieved 4 years ago. So we're introduced now to the Italian team. Goalkeeper at his third Olympic Games. Perez, the centre-back, relative rookie. Nicolo Gito, the right-hander who plays for Zagreb. Filioli, who's represented Australia at the Olympic Games before. Giorgetti's an interesting character. He was actually born in Budapest, so this is a big game for him as a Hungarian mother. For Lugo, who plays in Zagreb. Jacopo, the right-hander. Gallo, who played in Beijing 4 years ago, 6 foot 4 inches tall. Presciutti at his first Olympic Games. Fiorentini, who was born in Croatia. Icardi, who injured his right wrist in the lead up to the Olympic Games. Daniel Primus, born in Croatia, but now a naturalized Italian. And Pastorini is the second goalkeeper of the squad. So here the reigning Olympic champions. Sesci, the goalkeeper. Tamás Varga. Denis Varga, gold in Beijing. Tamás Kasás at his fifth Olympic Games. Norbert Hosniansky. Here's the one of the stars of the team, Gergely Kish. And Martin Sivos. Daniel Varga. He's actually a contemporary painter as well as a water polo player. Peter Birosh, three gold medals in his collection. Adam Steinmetz. Alash Harai, first Olympic Games, one of the younger members of the squad. And goalkeeper Victor Nedge. Dinesh Kemeni, the coach of the Hungarian water polo side, appointed in 1997, who really has done terrific work with them. One of our referees is from Greece, and the other from Kazakhstan. So the evening session about to get underway in the water polo arena. If you're new to the sport, 4 8-minute periods. That stop watch there counts the seconds that you're allowed to have a shot in possession. Only 30 seconds when you have the ball, you have to get a shot away, otherwise you have to turn possession over. All smiles in the face of the Italian coach, Alessandro Campagna. He's scored two goals in Italy's victorious Olympic gold medal final in Barcelona back in 1992. Probably guessed by now, Italy in the white bathing caps. Their date with destiny, their date with the Olympic champions, Hungary. Two there is Perez. There's the goalkeeper, Tempestini. Ten is Fiorentini, whose father, Branko Jovanovic, played for Yugoslavia water polo. Quick check on the Italian lineup then. The star man for me so far in the championships has been number 12, Daniel Primus, who had a chance to compete for Montenegro, Georgia and Macedonia when he decided to change his nationality and he chose to play water polo for Italy. Italy's results then. Let's concentrate on those three victories against Australia, Kazakhstan and Spain. Lost to Croatia, arguably the in-form team here at London 2012. Hoping to make a real splash in the next half an hour of competitive water polo. He's been there, done it, and got the t-shirt. Can his Italian charges do the same and take gold back to Italy? Hungarian side, Biros and Kis, hoping to become the first ball-playing Olympians to win gold medals four times. Biros is the captain. One or two eyebrows were raised when Hungary lost their opening two games against Serbia and then Montenegro, but they turned things around with victories against Romania, Great Britain and the USA. If it is to be the end of the road for Denis Kemeny. Kemeny actually means tough in Hungarian, and a tough task in prospect here. He was named into the International Swimming Hall of Fame, which is open to all aquatic sports, in 2011. There is his star man, Biros, number 10. But Biros and Kis really run this team. This aging team have another hurdle to clear. Final few words of encouragement for the Hungarian side. Certainly a feeling that Hungary just gets stronger and stronger the longer they go on in a tournament. Well, I wonder whether that's going to be the case here. Hey, can you give me the ball? Thank you. We're just about ready for the swim-off to start the game. Only seven players allowed in the pool, unlimited substitutions. Kashash will be the swim-off expert for Hungary. The third quarterfinal of the men's water polo competition at the London 2012 Olympic Games is underway. Hungary, the Olympic champions in the blue caps against Italy in white. Fiorentini has won the sprint off. Italy in possession right at the start. Minor foul. Italy still in possession. Foul is by the Italian, Icardi. That puts Hungary onto the front foot here. Well, the front crawl, probably a better description. This is going to be a real test for the Italians in white. They're trying to get the backhander shot away there with Harai. And we have the first exclusion foul against Nicolo Ghito. So Hungary have the extra player and a great opportunity for the opening goal. Here's a power play. They haven't got the shot away yet, and it's blocked. And then they hit the upright, and an Italy escape. And there's a furious sprint towards the other end of the water polo pool. Driver coming in from the left. That's a terrific block. Shot was by number six, Falugo. Italy will build again. Italy finished second in Group A after their results. 24 of Italy's 40 goals have come from extra man situations. And now they have an extra man. Although that's an outstanding stop by the Hungarian goalkeeper. Sesci did really well here. Great reaction save to deny Jacopo. Italy's record of playing Hungary at the Olympic Games is poor. They've played Hungary 12 times, winning only twice. Gallo driving forward now for Italy. No foul. Rather quizzical look by the Italian player towards the referee. Tennis Biros. Oh, that's a great interception. Oh, the animated figure of the Hungarian coach, Kemeny. Jacopo. Jacopo again. Italy ran out of time. The stopwatch indicated 30. Shot clock ran out. So Italy have to give possession back to their Hungarian rivals here. Shot. Rare shot off target by Biros. That's a rematch of the Sydney 2000 quarterfinal, where Hungary won by 8-5 on their way to the gold medal. Turnover foul. Not that Hungary agree with that. Their team are in possession now. Maybe those Hungarians were complaining about the holding by Varga, and that's what's been given by the referee. You see the shot clock at the top of your screen. They have to get a shot away before the 30-second mark. Looked like that ball was in, but it wasn't. Quiche going close, but not close enough. It remains 0-0. I wonder if the lack of goals indicates a very tight game. Both teams have had plenty of opportunities to score, and yet the scoreline remains resolutely blank. Quiche with the defensive block. Exclusion foul here against Fiorentini. So an opportunity here for the opening goal. And there is the opening goal, chipped in brilliantly. Opening goal of the game from Keshash. Lovely ball into the middle, that's where the exclusion foul happened, incidentally. So Italy are a goal down to Hungary. And it's Tamás Keshash playing into his six Olympic Games. Bit of space here for Italy. They need a quick response. And they've managed to smuggle the ball in. Presciutti makes it 1-1. Not much to aim at here, but he didn't need much. Just got goal side of his marker. Steinmetz. So good response by the Italians in what is proving to be a pretty tight game so far. Oh, there's some pushing and shoving going on. It's not too pleasant. Involving Keshash. Icardi sees his shot blocked. So many attacks have foundered on excellent defensive play and excellent pieces of goalkeeping, and that was another example with Sesci doing really well. That's a great ball into the middle. It's so easy for Hungary. Nobody picked up Varga, and Varga's sprint into the middle opens up the Italian defence. It's now 2-1. Italy just switched off then. Denis Varga plays for Zagreb. Bit of blood around the nose, I think, there of Varga. So I think he's being asked to leave the pool. Game can restart now, and Varga can get some running repairs to his bloodied nose. Thank you. Another great steal, this time by Hosniansky. And Hosniansky then puts the ball between his elbows and moves prominently forward. Into the last 60 seconds of the first quarter. Low scoring game so far. Oh, clever play by Steinmetz, but that was not on his side. Not quite judged well enough, but pretty close. Perez. Terrific time for Italy to find an equalising goal. Twice now Hungary have taken the lead. Twice now Italy have responded. Long distance goal by Mauri Perez. Just 9 seconds left. So the hooter sounds, what has been a close game. Absolutely nothing to separate these two sides. Hungary have twice taken the lead. Italy have twice pegged them back. After the first quarter, it's Italy 2, Hungary 2. I think the key to that first period was how many times both teams had shots on goal and they were either blocked by defenders or goalkeepers. It's going to be that sort of game though. 2-2 at the end of the first period. Filioli swims off here against Madrash to start the second period. Italy win the swim off. Filioli doing really well. Player born in Rio in Brazil. Italy yet to lead in this match. Long way way to go though. Shot clock is almost elapsed, and just in time, Italy take the lead. Falugo. Long way out. Daniel Varga got a hand to the ball but couldn't keep it out. Falugo. It's another good block, but Italy have won it back. Italy plotting. Pivot player calling the play. They all change positions. All rotate. Jetty claiming he was fouled. Is that going to be a penalty? It's an exclusion foul against a Hungarian. But did he deny a shot on goal? The answer is no. Exit Daniel Varga. Italy have an extra player in the pool here. Oh, it's a fine stop. Excellent goalkeeping again by Sesci. It sets Hungary forward again. And again, the defences are particularly strong. Both Hungary and Italy have defended superbly. That's why we've only had five goals so far, and we're midway through the second period of the match. Falugo. Shot by Primus is easily blocked by Biros. And the action in the second half. Or second period, very much similar to the action in the first period. Both teams managing shots on goal, but very often blocked or saved. Not that time. An equalising goal for Hungary, scored by Madrash, his first goal of the game. Norbert Madrash, Hungary's top goal scorer. That's his 12th goal of the Olympic Games competition. Jacopo exits the pool. He knows there's a long way to go yet. Exclusion foul. Sivosh. Italy have the extra player. The be denied so many times, but not that time. They're in front again. Pleshuti scores his second goal of the game. Shooty playing in his first Olympic Games, but this could be a very interesting quarter-final. Is this where Hungary's crown as Olympic champions begins to topple? Already lost to Serbia and Montenegro. Turnover foul. Foul by Steinmetz. Stayed out. Mixture of goalkeeper and frame of goal to deny Valentino Galli, big 6'4" player. But it wasn't the frame of the goal, it was the frame of the player. That's a wild shot driven in by Dennis Varga. Skip shot, which skipped well wide. Italy with the advantage. Just one goal in it. Sivosh trying to help create an opening. That's a big shot by Fiorentini, beaten away. Italy will hang on to possession. All swap, gentlemen, please, and that's exactly what they do. Perez trying to evade his marker. Not easy, trying to get away from Cashash, who's all over him. Bit of space here for the driver on the right. Cardi with a turnover foul, that's quite a tattoo, isn't it? And four here is Dennis Varga. Cashash helps it back to Varga again. Eight is Sivosh. Another big, big block there. Tempestini starts another attack. Can they convert this one? Is that an exclusion foul? It is on Sivosh. But I think a timeout's been called. Indeed it has, by the Italians. First timeout of the game. This is Madrash, top scorer for Hungary. Game restarts. Italy still have the extra player. slight mistake there by the Italians. The shot clock might be a problem here, but they do have a power play. Harai is out of the pool. Hungarian fans don't agree with that. Oh, it strikes the crossbar. Italy denied right in front of goal. Persciutti going close. I think he thought he'd scored. Stays out. 4-3 to Italy in this second period. Now there's an Italian exclusion. It's Dennis Varga. What an opportunity for Hungary to draw level before we hit the end of this half. And they do just that. Daniel Varga. Two teams are sharing 8 goals at the moment. Player who, away from water polo, is a contemporary painter and has 3 or 4 exhibitions a year. You'd hardly guess that, seeing him in the pool. Meanwhile, exiting the pool, the Italian number 5, Alex Giorgetti, who was born in Budapest and has a Hungarian mother. Hungarian goalkeeper asking his team to be vigilant here in these last few seconds, and they weren't. Oh, they weren't. Filioli. Secchi will not be pleased. There was a big gap in front of him, and Filioli, who represented Australia once at the Olympic Games, has scored right at the end of the second period. And that's half time. So not too many goals in this game, just 9, which is pretty low. And at the halfway point, it's Italy 5, Hungary 4. So a quick check on the match statistics. The Olympic gold medal holders down by the odd goal in nine. Can Italy hang on to the advantage against a Hungarian side who haven't had it all their own way here at London 2012? Here we go. Second half is underway. This is the third quarter. And who will win the swim-off between Italy and Hungary? It's won once again by Italy, who lead by 5-4. This a quarter-final match between Italy in the white caps and Hungary, the Olympic champions. Ambitious attempt on goal. You can see the shot clock was running low. Sivas already has two exclusion fouls against him. Now there's an Italian player on an exclusion foul. It's Perez. So an opportunity for Hungary to draw level with the extra player. They do just that. Madrash, who scores for fun. Five all. Look at the space here for Madrash, the left-hander with a powerful shot. Ideal start for Hungary. Can't see too many goals in it by the end of this quarter-final. Holding going on in the middle, surely there is an exclusion foul against the number six, Wozniacki. Italy have the extra player. Oh, it's a fabulous save, and the ball ends up on the top of the net rather than it. And Seshi to the rescue. Corner threat. Powerfully put away. Filioli. Six goals to five, Italy lead. Well, if Hungary are going to progress into the semi-finals, they're going to have to do it the hard way. Because Italy look pretty steely determined to reach the last four and play in a medal match. Hosniansky. Exit the Italian player. Filioli. Hungary have an extra player in the pool. Can they find an extra goal to make it 6-6? The shot's coming. And that's a fabulous piece of goalkeeping if he got his hand to the ball. Didn't. Struck the outside of the upright. Now this could be interesting. Can Italy spring a surprise here and take a two-goal advantage? They're camped on the edge of the five-metre line. And there's an exclusion foul here against Hosniansky. Here's the space, here's the shot, here's the goal. Two-goal lead for Italy. Falugo. His second goal of the match after this exclusion foul. They moved the ball around intelligently, created the opening, and Falugo with a perfect execution. Steal incomplete. Hungary have it back. And they miss with that shot from Kish. And a problem here for Kashash. Knee injury for one of their star players. Playing in his fifth Olympic Games. They need his experience in the pool and they need it quickly. Because Italy have a two-goal lead here. Couldn't help the ball over the goalkeeper. That was some miss. Get back, gentlemen, please. Still there's concern about Tamás Kashash. Another big block. You do feel you're at the crucial point of this match. Can Italy hang on? Can they just stop Hungary finding a goal? Madras. Little tip ball. And the Italian Gito is out the pool. Great defending by Italy, despite being a player light. Madras. Another big shot coming up here. Again, Italy get lucky. Hungary retain possession. And the third time, this time the fist salute of Tempestini tells its own tale. Three big attempts by Hungary, three times repelled by the Italians. And that signal by the goalkeeper could be telling, especially if Italy can score here. Italy win it back. Is this another goal? Penalty. I think the player was stopped as he was about to shoot. Penalty foul against Varga. And what an opportunity now for Italy. Giorgetti, who was born in Budapest, playing now for Italy against Hungary, and a chance to give Italy a three-goal lead. What a story we have here. And Hungary's crown is wobbling. Here's why the referee decided to award the penalty. Daniel Varga climbing all over the player who was about to shoot. Right down the middle. Cries of Italia, Italia from the stands here. One of the big Olympic water polo stories is just unfolding now, and the crowd just beginning to realise it. This just might be. An unbelievable night for Italian water polo. Still early days, but the waves are certainly heading in that direction. Filioli out the pool. Italy can take a three-goal lead into the break. It would be incredible. And once again, Italy have stolen the ball. He looks like a man resigned to his fate. Last couple of minutes, almost another goal. The tip there by Icardi almost found its way in. Filioli on two exclusion fouls. Another exclusion foul, this time against Jacopo. I think a timeout's been called. It has by the Hungarians. Both teams have now taken one timeout each. They're allowed another timeout each before we're done. Game restarts. Hungary pressing to reduce the arrears. Playing against a team with one player less. That hasn't gone in. Italy now back to their full complement of players. And a minute left now, the third period. 8-5 Italy lead. Did the goalkeeper get a touch? He claims he didn't. That's the way the referee saw it as well. Varga with two exclusion fouls against him. Has that gone in? Don't think it has. A little bit of luck here, perhaps, for the Italians. It stayed out. The Hungarian fans not happy about it. It remains 8-5. In the last 20 seconds now, the third period. Italy have lost the ball in a very dangerous position. Just a couple of seconds left. And there's the end of the third period. And he looks ready to explode. If there's ever going to be an examination of Hungary's credentials to be Olympic champions, it is now. At the end of the third quarter, they trail Hungary by 8-5. So we're ready for the swim-off. Last period about to commence. 8-5, Italy lead the Olympic champions Hungary. And Hungary in real trouble here. They're going to have to produce something exceptional in the last period if they are going to rescue this quarter-final. Exclusion foul. Is that ball going to cross the line? Well, the answer is no. Extraordinary scenes here. Look at that for a pass. About 25 metres that ball travelled.
Yeah.
Shot clock was running low. That's why Hungary had to hurry there. Madrash on target. But the goalkeeper was right behind it. Gito has picked up two exclusion fouls. The next goal is going to be crucial here. If Italy can score it, they must feel they have an outstanding chance of success. Big block, huge block for Madrash. Back come Hungary again. Penalty here for the Hungarian team. Penalty foul against Falugo. So an opportunity arises here for Hungary right at the start of the fourth and final quarter. How they could do with Tempestini pulling off a huge save. Peter Biros given the responsibility for Hungary. And he puts away the penalty. Two goals in it now. Is this where Hungary stage the comeback of all comebacks? Then right over the head of the goalkeeper. Tempestini given a little opportunity of saving this penalty from Biros, who scores his first goal of the game. The lead now just two goals. Little lob, oh, it just strikes the upright. Really clever play then from Falugo. Just drifts wide, and that gives Hungary the opportunity to counter-attack through Peter Biros. Biros with the ball into the middle. Turnover. And an exclusion here against Biros. And Italy are in the clear. Can they convert? Surely, surely, surely. Filioli. Filioli in the clear, and I wonder how big that goal will be. Italy's lead back up to three goals now. Real buzz around the stadium because these fans could well be watching a bit of history. And every missed opportunity sees Hungary drowning. And their hopes of taking gold are just beginning to disappear. Biros involved in that incident. Not the most accurate of passes. Fiorentini. Cashash, who's been struggling with a knee injury. Oh. prior to London 2012, Hungary hadn't lost an Olympic match since a preliminary round game at Sydney 2000. Well, they've lost a couple here to Serbia and Montenegro. And Italy are closing in on a very famous victory, though they do have an exclusion foul against Felugo. Hungary have the extra player. These have to start flying in, and they do. Kesesh. Kesesh scored the game's first goal to make it 1-0, and he's now made it 9-7. Getting close to the midway point of the final quarter. Just one goal for Italy so far in this quarter, scored by Filioli. That one kept out well. That's a big save by Sesci. An important save too. Skip shot landed right in front of him and got a strong forearm to the ball, and here comes the counter thrust. Varga. Quiche. Another goal for Hungary. They're right back in it. They've managed three goals in this last period, and now just a goal between the two countries. Maybe their obituary had been written far too soon. Dennis Varga. Timeout called by Italy. We've watched an 8-5 lead turn into a 9-8 lead. Osniewski with his second exclusion foul. Italy in real need now of a goal. They can't afford to give possession away again and allow Hungary up at the other end of the pool to try and make it 9-all. Hungary have a player out, Tamás Varga. Not scoring is not an option here for the Italians. Oh, they've just made a mistake there. Filioli. Goalkeeper keeps it out. They haven't scored. Another let off for Hungary. The tip not good enough to take the ball into the goal. Sesci lets out a yell. The Italian coach throws up his arms in frustration. And Hungary now on a late roll, but they haven't scored. They've missed two. And both teams exploring every way of not scoring. The next goal surely will be crucial. Italy have possession.
Stop clock is running. They have to get a shot away here. Vargas had his third exclusion foul. Both players, one from each side. Kish is out as well. As is Primus. Six aside. Might make it interesting. Less than 2 minutes remain. The Olympic champions have to score in this period, and they're more than capable of doing that. Italy doing all they can to frustrate. There's a big gap here, a huge gap. Varga unable to shoot. Good defending by Italy. Both teams up now to their full complement of players. Hungary, lovely feint. The shot clock is at 30. Let off for Italy. It's heart in the mouth stuff here for the Italians. They need a goal. If they score now, surely they'll make it. They can't afford to miss again, Italy. They have to score here. They've got it. It's a huge goal, a massive goal for Italy. That could be the goal to take them through. For Lugo. It means Hungary need two goals now, and surely their domination of the Olympic Games in the water polo competition is at an end. They know what that means. One or two tears in the pool, I suspect. It isn't over yet, but it almost is. Hungary need two goals to take us into extra time. Exclusion foul. It's against Gito. And Hungary have scored. They're not giving up without a fight. Madrash. So 10-9 to Italy. And let's look at the clock. 30-second shot clock. They can take their time. And then it'll be 9 seconds for Hungary to try and score an equaliser. They must use up this 30 seconds. Hungary are going to have a chance once this Italian attack is over. An exclusion foul here against Madrash. But surely that's going to do it now for Italy. Last 10 seconds. Last 5 seconds. Hungary are on their way out. And the goal right on the buzzer doesn't really matter. Hungary's 12-year dominance of the Olympic water polo competition is all over. What a story here. The Invincibles of Hungary are no more. They might have won 9 gold medals at the Olympic Games, but it is not to be a 10th. And the old guard of Hungary will need to be changed. Italy have been successful here. They're through to the semi-finals where they'll meet Serbia. They win by 11 goals to 9. Confirmation then. It's Italy against Serbia. And all the smiles from the Italian team. What a story. There is no place to hide after such a crushing defeat, especially when you've been kings of water polo at the Olympic Games for so long. And Italy are the new kids on the block. Italy will dispute a semi-final.